Thank you very much, Brian. This is our first night of live coverage from the Olympic Ice Hall, which is now filling up, and you can start to feel the excitement here as we get set for the pairs competition. About half the field has a chance for a medal. That's what makes this one very interesting. Barb Underhill, Paul Martini join me as usual. And Barb, clearly the focus for Søren Eisler going for gold.
Well, about the only way to describe Lloyd and Isabel today on practice was pumped. They're really ready. I don't think they could be more ready than they are right now.
Let's talk about their adversaries from the United team, Mishkatunik and Dmitriev. Paul?
Well, Chris, Mishkatunik and Dmitriev have competed twice in the past 6 months. One on this very ice surface at Lalik in the fall, and once 2 weeks ago at the European Championships. Neither time did they look sharp. Now, they've been in Mijev the past 2 weeks in a secluded type situation, practicing hard. We'll see if that practice helps them out here tonight.
All right, we believe this really boils down to a battle for gold between those two, but so many have a chance for bronze.
You're right, it is a two-way battle for the gold, but for the bronze, it's about a five-way battle. And it's going to be up to the teams that are mistake-free here tonight that will be in that bronze position.
Let's talk about our other Canadians, because I think one of those pairs, Paul, might be in that bronze medal position.
Well, with Huff and Lede, we have a team that's here for the second time. They were in Calgary in 88, and they've come here, and as Barb just said, they're one of those five or six teams that on any given night could be in a bronze medal position. With our third team, Ball and Wirtz, they're just a bundle of excitement. They were a team that went into Canadians with a chance of making the team, skated their way onto that team, have been here all week, they've been entertaining us, they've just been a thrill to watch, and it's their first Olympics, one I'm sure they'll never forget.
All right, it's going to be an interesting competition. Right now, two of the American teams are warming up behind us. Competition will start soon. We'll also have a series of features from Canadian judge Gene Sept on the judging process. Gene tonight will tell us what the judges are looking for in the original program.
In the pair original program, we've picked one of the eight required elements to highlight, so that you have a chance to evaluate these programs with this one item as your basis for comparison. It's called the pair twist lift.
In this lift, the man throws the lady into the air for two rotations, either in an upright position or a lateral position, the lateral being more difficult. Here are some things to watch for. The lady has the option of performing a split position on the way up. Check the height of the lady in the air. How securely is she caught in the air? If she is not caught, a deduction applies. How gently is she put down to the ice? Ensure the lady lands on one foot and that the man also exits the lift on one foot, or again a deduction applies. Canada's Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler perform one of the best twist lifts in the world. Lloyd throws Isabel so high into the air that he has time to clap his hands by his side before he catches her and puts her down beautifully to the ice.
In general, when comparing these twist lifts, try to assess the overall strength and speed of approach, which can be difficult, I know, if you're not sitting in the arena. But ask yourself, does the lift give you a sense of security and confidence when it is performed? Chris?